Hello there guys and girls! In this tutorial I want to teach you some stuff I learned about Open4, a tool that is essential for modding your GTA 5 game files. Now I know there are already other well-made tutorials about this software out there, but I think I can give you some additional tips and tricks on how to use the tool effectively for machinimas, which means you will also learn how to modify textures yourself. As always, all the links are in the video description below. I'm not gonna repeat that 100 times throughout this video.
Seriously.
Open4 is available on gta5mods.com. Alternatively, you could go to open4.com, spelled openiv.com. Other than regular mods, this is a tool you actually install on your system. I have already done that, obviously. After installing, you need to point out the directory in which your GTA 5 game files are located. I already did that too, obviously, so the prompt isn't popping up here. Then, every time you start Open4, you click on Windows or whatever system you're running on, but I'm assuming it's gonna be Windows. That kind of stuff explains itself up to now. For further preparation, you should navigate to your main game folder of GTA 5 and create an empty folder called Mods in there. Everything is lowercase. To install or remove all components of Open4, you click this little icon up here. In this screen, you can easily select and deselect the components, which is useful if you want to play online from time to time. In this case, your game folder needs to be clean and free of modifications. All these buttons do is to remove or copy the Open4 files to your game folder. If you don't know what Open Camera is, I recommend you to watch another tutorial I've made on that topic. It's really helpful. Let's dive into the modding now. Let's say you wanna use a custom car for your machinima. First, we're gonna talk about models that replace existing cars from the game. You just download a mod at gta5mods.com and unzip the archive. If you are lucky, the creator of the mod gives you the most recent path where the car is located in the README file. You just navigate there using Open4, just like the Windows Explorer basically. If you are not lucky, you have to search for the files yourself. Click this little search button here, and then you enter the exact name of the files you have downloaded. Open4 will prompt you with the results. Just double-click one of the results that matches, and you will find the correct destination. If there are multiple results, make sure to pick the most recent one, meaning that there are folders called patch day 1, 2, 3, and so on. Pick the one with the highest number. Once you have found the correct RPF archive and the right model, you can then click on Edit Mode up here. This mode lets you automatically save all the changes you make. Now you will notice a huge red pop-up here. This warning asks you to copy the RPF archive you are in over to the mods folder which you created before. Always click this button. If you don't do this and modify the original game files, the GTA 5 launcher will notice the changed file and download the entire RPF archive and overwrite the car you just replaced. So make sure to always work from inside the mods folder. You will notice that after clicking the button, the once empty folder is now equipped with a mirror of the file path of the RPF archive you copied. That was a damn long sentence. Now that you are inside the mods folder, you just open up the folder with the modded car. There are usually 2 to 3 files in there, one for the model, one for the texture, and maybe one for the high resolution texture. With the edit mode still active, you drag and drop the files into this list. To check if everything worked, you find the correct files and double click on them. You should now be able to see a preview of the car inside the pop-up window. You are now ready to test the mod. Click on the green arrow button to launch your game and you should be good to go. Just find the car you replaced and spawn it with menu or any trainer you prefer. While most car models will replace existing cars, there are also add-on models. In this case, you should also follow the instructions given by the mod creator. So in this case, I have picked a beautiful classic Mustang. To install it, you copy the entire folder called DOMC in this directory, which you might have to create first. Then you go to the DLC list XML, which is in this very directory and needs to be copied to your mods folder as well. Right-click the XML file and extract it to your desktop. Then open it with Notepad++ and add this line at the end there. Save the file and put it back into OpenFOR via drag and drop. Now the spawning of add-on cars works a little differently. You could use the add-on car spawner from GTA 5 mods, but that's pretty complicated and you can also do it with menu, which you should have installed anyway. In order to do that, you need to go back to the folder where you placed the add-on car and open up the file vehicles.rpf. In there you will find the correct name of the car model. Write it down if necessary. In the game, you just open up menu and start the vehicle spawner. Go to input model and type the name you just wrote down. Voila! The car will spawn. You don't have to do this every time though. Just switch to saved vehicles and save this model for later. Still, if this is too complicated for you, you could also try to just extract and rename the YFT and YTD files you've downloaded to replace a similar car from the game. I've tried this many times in the past because I was too damn lazy to use add-on cars. And it usually worked just fine. Here is a small comparison. On the left side you can see the model I replaced the Dominator with. And on the right side you have the add-on model. They do not differ very much, except for a little bit in height maybe. If you want to replace people in the game, it works just the same as it does with the cars. For instance, if you take this nice mod of Quiet, you navigate to the directory in there, copy the archive to the mods folder if you haven't already, and then drop all the files in there like it's hot potatoes. And voila, there is your modded character. Now let's get to the next level, shall we? If you want to modify existing textures from the game yourself, you don't necessarily need to download mods from the internet. OpenFOR lets you do all that. Additionally, you will need a DDS plugin for Photoshop or GIMP, which are free of charge. Let's say you want to change the texture of a shirt. It depends on which character the shirt belongs to. If you want to change clothing of Trevor, Michael or Franklin, I recommend you go to GTA 5 mods for inspiration and to quickly find the right name of the shirt. I did the same for the custom Vanova t-shirt in the music video with Trevor, where I used the Misfits shirt by MattyPunks18 as the starting point for my own texture edit. You can then go into the specified file location and once again copy the stuff into the mods folder. With the edit mode activated, you open up the YTD file of the shirt, pick the right variant and click on export selected. Do not change the file name and save it as a DDS file. If you don't want to use the DDS plugin for your picture editor, you can also export the texture as a PNG file. Still, I think it's better to work with the DDS here. In your image editor, you can now place any logo on the shirt. Make sure to scale it a little smaller because I noticed that in the game it will always look bigger. If only it were like that in real life too. Anyway, when you're done, make sure to reduce the image to a single layer, otherwise the DDS saving prompt by Nvidia won't show. I usually leave these options the way they are, which works fine. Then save the file. Now you go back to OpenFOR and into the file location within the mods folder. With the edit mode activated, open the YTD file again, or maybe you have just left it open. Select the texture and click replace. Now you pick the DDS file you just created. Then click save. If you did everything correctly, the texture should show up in the game, but you don't even have to boot the game to check if it worked. Just click on the texture file again to see if it's saved. In game, you might have to switch between textures of the shirt because many shirts have multiple of them included. If you want to edit textures for other pedestrians, you should go about it a little differently to find the right model. If you have found a suitable character model with your trainer, you should write down its name. Then you use OpenFOR search feature again to look for it in the game folder. Copy it to the mods and you are free to edit the files once again. As opposed to the three main characters, the pets usually have all their textures crammed into one YTD file. This means you will also find the facial features in there, which you can modify the same way you edited the shirt before. How about a nice scar in the face? Or some bitch-ass makeup? You can do the same as well for almost any object in the game. For instance, if you've seen my video, The Truth About Chemtrails, I added that this little pill box to show a different product name. It can be a lot of fun to change the game like that. There's one more thing I need to show you. When editing textures of objects, you will very likely come across models that don't have their textures stored in a separate file. Instead, they are embedded into the YFT files. In order to change the textures anyway, you need to do a few extra steps. There is a small portable tool called Texture Toolkit which you can download from gta5mods.com. This allows you to modify YFT files and others. Here's how to do it. For instance, there is this white fence, but let's say you need it to be brown for the machinima. Once again, you search for the object's name with Open4. After you've found the YFT file, you go ahead and extract it to the desktop. Back in Open4, you activate the edit mode, copy the RPF archive to your mods folder, and then you double-click on the YFT file, and in the bottom right corner, you will find the entry View Embedded Textures. Click on it and then choose to export all embedded textures. Now, I recommend that you copy all that stuff in some different folders to not get confused. So you should just make a folder called Fence Original or whatever and copy the files in there. Since the extracted textures are DDS files, you can once again use them in Photoshop and change their color. After you have saved them, the texture toolkit will do its job. Open it up. Click on File, Load, and then choose the YFT file that you have left on your desktop to be modified. Texture Toolkit will now show you the embedded textures. You just click on Import and choose the correct texture to be replaced. Save the file. Now you go back to Open4 and drag and drop the file you just modified into the folder. To check if it worked, you can then double-click the YFT file and view the embedded textures. Well, and this is how it looks in-game. So yeah, this is how you utilize Open4 effectively. If you have any questions or if I have missed something important in your opinion, please post a comment and I will try my best to help you out. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Vanova, over.